Hi guys, so today I have come up with a video on cherubism, which is a very important topic of oral pathology. It has been seen in your exams like many a time, so I have taken these notes from the book of Schaeffer's of oral pathology. So these are very important ones, so you need not go and read it from the book. I have done the work for you. And these are the also first very important thing is wherever I have marked, I have star marked the things, you have to make a note of it, because these are the questions which have been asked in Viva's. So, but before moving ahead, I request you all to please subscribe to my channel and press the bell notification on and hit the bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video, you get the notification of it and you can watch it. Okay, so let's start with the topic for today. So the topic is cherubism. Now the question asked is, what is the other name of cherubism? So the other name is familial. So the other name is familial fibrous dysplasia. It is a developmental jaw condition and it is seen more commonly in children. That is why it is called disease of children. And it is an autosomal dominant condition. So these are the four basic points about cherubism. I hope you all are able to learn it here itself, that it is a familial fibrous dysplasia, it is a developmental jaw condition, it is a disease of children, and it is autosomal dominant. Okay. Now the gene which is involved over here is SH3BP2. Okay, so this is the etiology. Etiology is it is genetic, it is seen due to mutation in gene which is SH3BP2. Now what is the pathogenesis of this? The pathogenesis of cherubism is that there is some mutation in the gene which is SH3BP2. Now in normal scenario, what happened, this gene is responsible for maturation of osteoclast cells. Now you must be wondering, what are osteoclast cells? So the osteoclast are basically, they are the cells which are responsible for replacement of old bone tissues. Okay, so what happened, if in case of cherubism there is a mutation in SH3BP2 gene, this lead to increased production of osteoclast, due to which there will be cyst like formation, and which leads to a condition called cherubism. Okay, so this was all about pathogenesis. Now moving ahead to the clinical feature. Clinical feature is very important about the cherubism, and the features which have been asked, what are the features seen in cherubism? So there will be three basic features: in facial appearance, in eyes, and cervical lymphadenopathy. Okay, in case of facial appearance, you see plumped cheek appearance. Okay, so that is why the name is also given cherubism, because this gives a cherub like appearance, which is little angel. Next, it is seen in 2 to 5 years of age, so that's why it is seen in children. It progresses until the puberty, and after puberty it starts regressing. By second decade it gets normal. Okay, so this was about facial appearance. Next is the eye. In case of eyes, these features are important. These are only four features. So the eyes are upturned to heaven, they expose sclera below the iris, there is tilt of eyeball upward, and there is infraorbital rim and orbital floor involvement. Okay, but in a very rare condition you see the loss of vision. Okay, so these are the only 4 or 5 points. So eyes upturned to heaven, explore sclera, tilt eyeball upward, infraorbital rim and orbital floor involvement. This is about the eyes, and also there is involvement of cervical lymphadenopathy. If mandible is involved, it is there will be bilateral swelling in the posterior region, and it will be a painless one. So only 3 point, that bilateral swelling, painless in the posterior region. But maxilla involvement is very rare, and if it is involved, it gives a very ugly appearance, and the appearance is also named, so it is called as grotesque face. So the question being asked is, grotesque face appearance is seen in which condition? So you will say that it is seen in cherubism, or other way around the question can be that in case of cherubism, if maxilla is involved, what sort of appearance does it give, and what is it named? So you will call grotesque face. Next, if teeth are involved, they get displaced and there will be speech difficulty. This is all about clinical feature. Next, moving on to the radiographic feature. In radiographic feature, only two points are important, which are also asked in VIVAs. So the first one is it gives floating teeth appearance and ground glass appearance. So I'll explain you in detail also. In radiographic feature, the first point which you have to learn that there is multilocular radiolucency with expansion of both the jaws, and there is thin cortical plate involvement. Thin cortical plate, okay, and multiple unerupted teeth are seen. Due to resorption of alveolar bone, it gives a floating teeth appearance. Next, in later stages, what you see, there is patchy sclerosis in radiolucency. That is why it gives a ground glass appearance, okay? So this is about radiographic feature. Next, moving on to the histopathologic feature. In histopathologic feature also, only two points are important. First one is multinucleated giant cell, which are osteoclastic cells. Second is there is osteoclastic cuff around the blood vessels. Even if you forget the rest of the point about histopathologic feature, you can remember only these two points. So still I will explain you the other ones also. The first is vascular fibrous connective tissue. Second is loosely arranged stroma. Third point is there is small giant cells. So if you have to remember the rest points also, then you can learn it by this mnemonic, very simple one. That is SLOV, SLOV. So S stands for small giant cells, LO for loosely arranged stroma, V for vascular fibrous connective tissue. And I think you know this, multinucleated giant cells, which are osteoclastic cells, and eosinophilic cuff around the blood vessel. Even if you forget the rest three, just remember these two points. Next is the treatment, which is less important for you, but okay, so this observation is important in case if you observe it. So there you will see that it is regressing, but if it gets worsened, there is curettage is done in case it gets worsened. So this was all about cherubism. I hope now it has made things clear in your mind, and you will be able to learn this for your exams and for your VIVAs. And so I hope